Hey up baggers, Bertie Bagger here, back out on the road again. We're off today to one of the most anticipated matches every year. It's the Dave Roberts Memorial up on the Shropshire Union at Knighton. Dave was one of my old mates from work when we all used to work at the Cadbury's factory. And I've known him since a kid, since we all used to go round his old mother-in-law's house down Chinatown. Known him for years. DA, or the Owl as he's known to most people. Lovely bloke, loved his fishing. So we're here today to have a match in his memory. Fortunately, I won the very first one, which was an honour. And I love that, having that. And I ended up with a red letter day on the Honeysuckle Stretch in Newport Canal 3 years ago. I had £50 of silvers, one after another. Couldn't go wrong. Set the record for the venue as well. But today, I'm gonna try and win my title back because Tone Austin currently holds it. I wanna get my name back on that trophy again. So we're here today, there's 30 booked on. I don't think that many will turn up, but we'll see. Hopefully they are. Hopefully you've been looking at my other videos on the Shroppies. This today can be used as well by the National Juniors as preparation for their match in a week or two, which on the same venue. So keep your eyes peeled for other videos getting uploaded this week. Remember, like and subscribe. Press the bell, make sure it's ringing so you get the notifications of when a video gets uploaded. And any recommendations or things you'd like me to cover in videos, I keep saying it, but keep sending me the comments or an email or whatever method of communication you want to use. And when time permits and when the snoring walrus lets me, we can all get out and have a do, and try and cover some of the things you want. So it's an early draw, it's an 8 o'clock draw. Done a start meet, that's Tone Austin for you. So we'll get to the draw, pick a peg. Probably help out a bit today, give Tone and Lee a hand, as they kindly put it on every year with their hard work. Fair play to you lads, thank you very much. We'll draw the peg, get to the venue, get set up, and we'll have a look at what we're going to do today. Tight lines, baggers. See you later. Hey up, baggers. Bertie Bagger here. We're here back again today on the Shropshire Union, in between bridges 47 and 48 on the Happy Days Angling Club section. Lovely section along here. Hopefully some nice weights come out of here. Tricast lads from Rochdale were down here. Brought the team down a few weeks ago. Again, some good weeks come, good weights come out that week. I think £28 won it, £21 second, £15 third. So some good weights. Hopefully we can get a bit of that going today. It's a memorial match today, so we've got kids, women, blokes. Bit of fun really. But hopefully you can use today's match, watching this back. It's some of the juniors who are fishing the National Junior Championships in a couple of weeks. Can pick up a few tips, learn what not to do on your match, learn from me. So today's approach, there's 30 pegs in today, and I've drew peg 29 right up the far end towards bridge 48, right on the edge of the wood on the far bank. And it's the end peg because nobody's drew peg 30 today, so I'm happy with the draw. So today's approach, if any of you have watched the video, well, you won't have watched it because it hasn't uploaded yet. It's doing it while as we speak at home. I set it up this morning. How to fish the inside line on the Shroppie. That video's uploading today, so I'm using that same rig for that. So just fishing the length of my top two. It's mainly for the juniors and the cadets who have to fish no more than 3 meters for 90 minutes during their match. So it's to show them how to work that line. So I'll be using that today. As you know, full length of the top two, fishing to hand, so we can do a bit of speed fishing, swinging them roach, perch and gudgeon in, and skimmers. So as you should know by now, because it's the same rig, we've got 010 mainline down to my little Chianti style float. Beautiful Garbolino DC C32, 0.3 gram, thin bristle, carbon stem. Give it nice stability, trotting along that inside line. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 number nines evenly spaced out in a shirt button pattern to give that rig a nice slow fall through the water, so anything fishing, swimming around will see that bait falling down and intercept it. Coming down to us, a 12 inch hook length of 0.09. okay, with two number 12 droppers on, super slow fall right at the end. Coming down to good old Kamazon B911, not B511 like I said on a previous video. Kamazon B911's good old traditional classic hook, fine wire, that's what I'll be using. I'll be fishing that, the sloppy ground bait mix which you've seen, with a bit of breadcrumb mixed with Super Cup, Vandenine Super Cup, half and half. Okay, haven't gone for any Census Lake mixed in today because I thought there was too many large particles in the lake mix, so I've left the lake mix out today. Then my far bank swim, I say far bank, two thirds of the way across, just plumb up, find the middle, just as that starts to come up about a foot, and then fish that far line on the chop worm. And I've beefed it up a bit here, so we've got 015 main line with again the same float but with a yellow bristle to help with the help me to see it on the far bank under the shade of the trees. 0.3 gram Chianti style float, same carbon stem coming down. Shotting pattern, I've got four number nines in a bulk just above the hook length. Okay, so it's a 12 inch hook length, so about 13 inches I've got the bulk. Get that bait down there fishing straight away. And same as the other rig, two number 12 droppers evenly spaced, 4 inches, 8 inches from the hook. But we're on a 012 hook length, slightly beefier. So I'll hopefully pull out a couple of bonus fish on a number size 18 hook, okay? Kamazon B911 size 18. That's what I'll be fishing the chop worm. And for fishing down the track, I'll be fishing 8 meters out at 10 o'clock position to my swim, in line with a marker post I've got on the far bank. So straight in the, find the deepest part of the canal, and that's where I'll be fishing this main line. I'm gonna not straight away, but I'll eventually, when I feel the time's right, cup in 3 balls of ground bait laced with squat, the same slop mix I'll be using on the inside line, but laced with squat to put in that centre track line. Give that a good hour to sit, hopefully fish moving and find that. So again, same as the far bank rig, 015 main line, coming down to an Avanti Imola style float, 4x14s, it's about half a gram float, bit more stability, give a bit more weight and stability in the water. Rugby ball style shaped, thicker bristle, again give a more positive bite and more stability. I've got two spaced out bulks, so we're fishing about 4 foot depth. At 2 foot I've got my first bulk, which consists of four number nines right there. Coming down to the second, late shout to the all in. Coming down to a second bulk, again four number nines, 12 inch hook length, coming down to two number 12 droppers, and again an 012 hook length down to a Kamazon B911 size 18 hook. And I'll start off fishing 6 inches over depth, so half of that hook length is lying on the bottom. Okay, we've just heard the all in. So let's get cracking. Tight lines, baggers. start off. Bit of slop and a pinch of squat on this inside line. Get that feeding. When we start off, I'm going to go over, pot in a pot of chopped worms. A big piece of worm, see if I can catch a bonus fish straight away. Not that far. Roach to start with. Get all that slime off your line. put another number 9 down on my bulk, it's too much. Just putting a, took that back off, swap it for a number 10. Good start though, bagger. Keep that squat going. couple of minutes there now, with no bites on that far string. Since then, bugs have been through. So I'm just going to pot out a pot of chopped worms with some dead reds in. And I'm going to leave it and come and have a look on this inside line. And later on, I'm going to start pinging a few dead reds over the top. Try and draw some fish into the swim. So there we go. Have a look, see if anything's moved into this inside line. Got a single dead red maggot on the hook. No, fishing the wrong rig. Same one up. Single
that for a good hour. Check the time. Half 10. We've been fishing an hour. We've got about a pound and a half in there. Put in any weir on the far side, yeah. I'll just see if anything's moved in this way. Plus there's two boats coming, so it's time to make pour a cup of tea. Perch has obviously been eating some fish because he swallowed it down, went up, disgorged him and got the hook out. There was a little eyeball. The fish's eye on the hook. Far line isn't producing quick enough, so we'll go and have an early look on the middle line down the track, see if anything's moved into that ground bait and feed that I put in. They've had half an hour to move in and feed. I'd like to have left it a bit longer. circumstances mean we've got to go over a bit earlier. So no feed, let's just put it in, see if anything's moved on. Another two number eights to each bulk. Number nines. Still sitting too high. taking this slop ground bait mix, I'm going to mix up some dried breadcrumb super cup and introduce a new swim over at about 11 o'clock, same depth as the other far chop worm swim, and have a go on the bread punch on that. Had one ball of breadcrumb and super cup mixed together, nice and dry, just so it breaks up as it falls down through the water. I'm just going to go back on the chop worm arm while I give that 5-10 minutes to rest, to settle. switch to a single mid mag. There you go.
How
are you doing? You can take the girl out of Newport.
Piss on the side of the canal, she's going to go find a secret spot.
Oh, foul up the goodie. Side of the head.
I can see you.
Oh, banging heavy.
Why?
I don't know.
You're a bit out on the swell, aren't you?
Have I, heck?
Been Walter.
I do not get.
Why not?
It's climbing the fucking mountain.
How you keep it, hurry. Huh?
Hey?
How you keep it?
Oh, not so bad.
Mum alright.
Hey?
The mother alright.
Oh, we're sound, yeah.
I've seen her for ages.
She don't go out much, do you?
No.
anything as well.
Tell Dave, you've got a brain.
Got a brain?
Yeah.
I wish I had.
You got a brain?
Maybe.
I think it was a brain.
No, I saw you got. Yeah. Give him a brain.
I think it was a brain.
Well, go home.
May not
have had it in.
It may not have been, but.
It may not have been.
It was a fish, wasn't it?
Well, go.
Mummy needs a wee, come on.
Come on.
Go, follow.
116 last count.
Jesus Christ.
Here he is.
Is
he any good?
Well, that's small stuff.
Oh, plenty of small stuff.
Oh.
Taking part, mate, it fucking counts, isn't it?
Two rocks.
Yeah, they probably work these because they're not mine.
These are the
ones.
You wouldn't need the tripod, mate, to be honest.
Yeah, I'm going to tell you. It's good to tell you about the tripod.
Let's
see how it... Good time we don't need the tripod.
Nah.
But no, I don't need to fit it on, so we don't need it. You know we have a chain on the fucker.
There you go, mate. You happy with that?
Yeah, just come this side, mate, so we'll have to drag it all over.
Yeah.
I'll do this.
I've caught pretty steady all day.
Have you?
Until the last 45 minutes when the tow stopped. You see?
Yeah. Well, every time we had them down there, me fucking Phil, as soon as them boats hit us the first hour, that was it, stopped it. Killed it completely.
I was praying for the boats to come, aren't
we? Yeah, fucking. There's still not much fucking shit up down there, because it's a bit shallow down there, isn't it?
Oh, he's got 10, 11 pound of fish here.
That's going to do it, isn't
it? Yeah?
Yeah.
Sure?
Yeah.
You don't be talking, yeah? Seven.